It is a bill whose effects could trickle down to the lives of all Kenyans due to its expected impact on the cost of food and other basic necessities. The VAT Bill 2012, which was scheduled for its first reading in Parliament this Tuesday, seeks to impose a 16% tax on key commodities, including milk, bread, wheat flour, maize flour, sanitary towels, and even mosquito nets. The bill will also impose tax on pharmaceuticals and agricultural inputs, including fertilizer, pesticides, and other farm inputs. At current prices, the cost of milk and bread is likely to go up by 6 shillings, while maize flour and wheat flour could cost up to 10 or 20 shillings more due to the expected increase in the cost of production, a scenario that attracted sharp protests in the House.
Every person has the right to be free from hunger. Now imposing VAT on basic things like foodstuffs, it is obviously going to affect this particular provision. By the time this bill comes to the House, government must have already exhausted, ensured there's public participation, Mr. Speaker.
Speaker Kenneth Marende, however, stopped debate on the bill, citing the absence of Finance Minister Njeru Githae. Marende asked the Cabinet and Treasury to re-evaluate the bill to avoid a lengthy debate on its constitutionality and its impact on the common man.
The attention of the executive, and in particular the Minister for Finance, is acutely drawn to those concerns.
Outside the House, opposition to the bill has been mounting, with farmers already up in arms against a possible increase in the cost of inputs, while consumers fear a return to high food prices.
Kenyans are already overtaxed, and I feel it is morally unfair to continue taxing Kenyans.
Processed milk. Ikiongezwa hiyo wakulima mjue, watu wa Nairobi na wengine wataikunywa kidogo, watapunguza mnywaji wa maziwa.
For Citizen Business, I'm Henry Gedaiga.